It's our weekly update with the head coach of Jackrabbit Wrestling, Damian Hahn, who spent a few days and nights in Vegas and now is back here in beautiful Brookings. And the Cliff Keen Las Vegas invite, it was a challenge. It always is. And the Jackrabbits certainly represented them themselves very well. You get an individual champion, another that finishes in the top three. I would think you came out of there relatively pleased. Would you agree?
Yeah, I think with the field that went to the tournament, they added a couple new teams. They had us predicted taking 11th, 12th. We ended up top 10, so that's always a nice, bright little spot. Out of the top 10 teams, there were two mid-majors in the top 10.
Cornell and South Dakota State.
So it was an overall good event. Our guys got a lot of matches. Our guys got some upsets and climbed the rankings. So overall, we came away relatively healthy, and that's huge. We talked about that last week. But overall, I thought it was good.
You use this phrase a lot, and I understand why. Well, DeVos does what DeVos does, right? And he did it again as he takes care of business and wins the championship. But go beyond that a little bit. Why is Cade DeVos so good? What makes him tick?
Well, I think the biggest thing is his demeanor this year so far. You know, I always say that DeVos does what DeVos does. And I don't want to say there's more purpose behind it, but he's dialed in. And I think with, you know, he's a pharmacy major. You know, his academics are at the, I don't want to say at the top of his list necessarily compared to anything else. But he's dialed in. And the rigors of what he's going through, he's focused. And when he's doing what he's doing in the classroom and in the practice room, you're seeing the it translates over to his competition. Not that it wasn't that way before, but you just see a different side of it, right? And he's been training well, competing well. He's doing great academically. I mean, like, just I don't want to say he's a different person, but I've said this, you know, into the preseason, where he's a little different, you know, he's a little different this year than he has been in the past. And I think it's because of all the other things involved going on in his life right now. The dialed in, the focus component is showing. It really is.
How cool is that to see? We talk so much about the performance in whatever sport. In your case, certainly it's on the mat, and that's what gets all the attention. But as you watch somebody like Cade DeVos mature and become more involved in things and have attention diverted, and yet how he's able to channel himself and focus in this moment and succeed, you must take great pride in that as a coach.
Well, I don't believe they're mutually exclusive. You can have success both academically and athletically. And if you look at some of our better performers or wrestlers in general, or maybe even athletes in general, they have success in both because it all matters to them, right? It's not just the situation where I'm going to devote all my effort into this. No, I mean, they got to be well-rounded, and they're focusing their efforts in the right places. And you're seeing that with Cade. That's been really something unique to watch. So you could say, I mean, you know, you have guys at any university out there, and there are ones that are architectural majors, or they're studying pre-med, and you know, they're having success in both. And not to say that, you know, that has to be the case, but when those guys are more dialed in and just focused on the things, the tasks at hand, you're seeing the results that we have. And so it makes me extremely excited, because one thing that, you know, I've preached to kids that are looking at South Dakota State or recruiting in general, you go to college to get an education, and athletics is the vehicle that gets you there. And if you look at our overall program, you know, our goal for our team GPA is a 3.5. And we haven't hit that. We've been shy the past couple of semesters with 3.47, 3.46. And so there's a standard there. And when you hold a high standard, you know, the high tides raise all ships, right? Sure. And so that's the expectation going into our program. And you're seeing it both on the academic side and the athletic side.
At the Cliff Keen, aside from DeVos, who obviously wins it, is there somebody who, because of the draw, you said, I have a confidence, but he's going to get tested, and maybe it exceeds expectations, or got matched up with somebody who he struggled with and found a way to win that match? Is there somebody that really showed you something that maybe you weren't fully anticipating or just really impressed you?
No, we're with these guys all the time. And we see the potential. We see what everybody else does not. And it's nice to see some of those, the fruits of the labor, right? So you take the first two weights, you know, Tanner Jordan and Derek Cardinal. They've had some nice wins. And going into this tournament, we knew it was going to be a challenge. And I don't even know, I think Cardinal got seeded 14th, you know, out of the top 15 seeds. And I remember talking to, you know, the guys that ran the tournament the day before, and they didn't have him seeded. And I said, hey, man, you do what you got to do. And he ends up being in the semifinals, drops his semifinal match by a takedown to the number fourth guy in the country. He was right in that match to win it. And then drops into the semis, takes an injury, and then we had to pull him out after that. But, I mean, he knocked off I don't know how many ranked opponents in that competition where we know he can do that. It's nice for other people to recognize what's happening. And then you got a guy like Tanner Jordan who, you know, he picks up the win against Minnesota, who he's never beaten. That was a top five guy. He goes into Vegas and picks up more ranked wins. And in a tough fashion, right? I mean, that's what Tanner Jordan is. You know, I mean, if it comes down to a match where, hey, one guy's going to outlast the other, one guy's going to out-tough the other person, I mean, Tanner Jordan is the epitome of that. And so I think those two guys in particular this past weekend were a bright spot because we know how good they are. It's nice that everybody got to see how good they are. And then, you know, you go up and down the lineup, and I mean, it was tough competition. I mean, from whistle to whistle, man, every single match. And you know, you had a couple guys drop some matches, which they were in the matches, right? And one thing or another didn't go their way, but they wrestled the best competition in the country. And that's nice to see, because now you can make some adjustments on what needs to be done for them as individuals to take the next step and to get better and progress.
All right, so you got almost 2 weeks here between competitions because finals week, and that's a huge part of what we're talking about here, so it segues into it. So as we wrap this up, this is an important week, not so much from a wrestling standpoint, but because of the goals you have academically and for these individuals away from the sport of wrestling.
Yeah, we're heading into finals. We'll adjust our training schedule to accommodate what they need right now on the academic side, but there's no taking a step back. You know, we got to keep these guys close to the fire. So we'll make adjustments for the remainder of the week. I mean, we just got back on Sunday. We had other guys get back on Sunday. So we'll take these next couple days, let them kind of do what they need to do to prepare. And then we'll sprinkle in our training around their finals. Because, hey, we got Nebraska in 2 weeks, and that's going to be a dogfight, and we're going down there. So it's going to be it'll be a fun this week with finals, getting them kind of under wraps, and then we'll pick it back up and get them ready for Nebraska.